All right, today I'm going to talk a little bit about some side shoots that you might find up here in the 1,000 year time of genealogy. I'm over here with looking at this one, Siward of Northumbria, and I'm going to head into this one over here, Earl Uhtred the Bold. Both of them are pretty powerful in the region of Northumbria. Now, Northumbria, where is that? It's pretty much Yorkshire. Now, these guys, they came though not from Yorkshire. This particular one, Siward, came from Denmark. And he's very, very well known for, getting there, becoming Earl. And, in the very beginning, he didn't have all of Northumbria, but eventually he became to own it, And so he was the Earl of the zone. And he did fight quite a bit. He fought with Macbeth. He did not kill Macbeth, but he ends up in Shakespeare's play. So you might hear Siward mentioned. He was kind of an important character in the play. So, but not his actual murderer. He did defeat him though in battle. So, a few years before he died. So, but yeah, this is pretty much all about the Northumbria area. Now, Yorkshire, I've been there. It's kind of cold and damp, dreary. It's a little bit almost like an Ireland, but it has a little bit more coming in from ocean breeze from the, I guess, the North Sea. Yeah, so it's not as it doesn't rain as much as Ireland, but it has its troubles with weather also. Now he's associated with Kelly Castle, and Kelly Castle comes up a lot. And so I'm going to show a picture of Kelly Castle. Let's see, who did he marry? See, in this one, I have that he married, they have her called Bernicia, but really I've never seen that. I've only seen the Eifled name. And she, I guess she was just a local, so I don't believe she was from Denmark. And when I say Denmark, really they try to say that he was from the Swedish area as well. So he was more of they called him the Cnut. It was King Canute, and he was one of King Canute's favorites. So him and King Canute were very much into that zone. They do say that Siward himself went into Cumberland, which is the opposite side of England. And so in a way, this is kind of oddly pivotal, because this is all around the same time of the what is his name? William the Conqueror. And William the Conqueror was a what? Yeah, that big fight with Scotland. So in history time, this Earl here, this is very, very much a problem. This Earl fought the Scottish king Malcolm, and he beat Malcolm's army. to such a degree that they cut their heads off, and the women, I said, this is really written, the women actually wash the heads of the Scottish soldiers in the rivers. So, and then after that, they put their heads on poles. So they did a little bit of that Ivan the Terrible routine. So this is kind of a very bloodthirsty line right here that I've found. This Earl Uhtred. And I believe Uhtred is now today in this time frame, they sell artist supplies. Very similar name. And they call this guy the Bold, and I don't know, God, those women sound pretty, whoa, I think I'll just grab a head and wash it in the river and then stick it on a pole. So these were the women of this Durham. And Durham is that right there at that border, Scottish border to England. He had three wives, this one, the Earl had three wives. And this particular one, Sigun, I believe, was the second one. And nothing special around her. It was the first wife he had. There was something that did not go well with them, and she was given an ousting, and I'm not sure what happened, but his first wife, they have a special word name for it. I'll try to find it, because I thought it was interesting wording that they would do. These were all in historic blood feuds, it's saying here. They were all in a big feud over this whole territory, really, which would be the wall, Hadrian's Wall zone, all those years. So here we have this is one of the sons. Okay, so no, I don't want to be on the sons page. Apparently the killing of Uhtred. Uhtred was killed by Thurbrand, who had started a blood feud. So Thurbrand was the one who'd started it. Anyway, it lasted for many, many years. And a lot of avenging and vengeance going on back and forth. So it wasn't the greatest, but this Uhtred's dynasty, it was called a dynasty. It continued to reign in Bernicia, like his reign, his dominance. And he was killed though in 1038, and his son took over. I'm not getting into big history today. I'm kind of wiped out. So I'm just going to talk about what? Oh, the death. Yeah. Ethelred's son, Edmund Ironside. There was a campaign there. So, and back to Cnut. His forces were very strong, and Uhtred couldn't fight them. So this is odd, because now Cnut, who invaded Yorkshire, ends up in the long run with one of his faves, ends up marrying one of Uhtred's daughters. I believe that's the way it went. So we have him. This guy here, he's fighting the Cnut, and yet along comes Oh, I'm sorry, this is a son. His son has this Bernicia, the Aethelid, and this one marries, ends up marrying one who's a befriending of Cnut. So that kind of, it was a big fight, kill, and then here we have the son who ends up with a daughter that goes right back and marries into that aggressive line again. So, well, not because it wasn't, they weren't Cnut related, but they were Cnut supporter. So unsupporter of Cnut and then supporter of Cnut. It happened very quick changeover. Okay, so let's go look at Kelly Castle, and Siward had something to do with this one. I'm at Alame today. Maybe Alame is interesting. They do put a lot of those tags on everything. Yeah, this looks like a nice grounds for garden and all. They have they had a better photo of it. But yeah, Kelly Castle. So we're at this, when you're thinking of Siward, I keep showing this one. I'm not really liking it because Siward is the one in the back. They keep talking about his death. So the throngs of death moment, I'm not sure what those people are doing there. So it's a kind of a weird image. And then they have him here on his deathbed, kind of looking like a real old man with a Barbary beard here. And it tells of the time, doesn't it? Because there he is, and look at the beds. They do not look comfortable. It does seem that there was a mattress, and if there was a mattress, maybe it was stuffed with straw or horse hair, or even, I guess it could have been stuffed with wool. But yeah, straw mattresses were pretty much the norm back then. He has kind of a nice little brocade here underneath him. And there he is with his sword. He's never going to leave without his sword. Yeah, so here he is on his deathbed. And you notice he has a loyal dog. Looks like a bit of an Irish setter. So that's kind of a neat feature. Who else is in here? Just some guy waiting. Any last words, Siward? Do you have any last words for us? Deathbed last words. All about that, you know. You know, where are the keys to the kingdom? Do you have the secret to the pirates' treasure? Who gets the kingdom next? And it wasn't all of England, no, but he was quite a powerful character because he had that vast area, you know, just all along the Hadrian's Wall. And further south. So yeah. Anyway, so I'm gonna see who else I got here. So they're waiting for something, for him to say something. Spend time with the. There are some images of him with the wings on his helmet. So I'm gonna go and try and find one of those. That's kind of a neat image. We have where's the, not any of that. I'm over here with this right now. Yeah, I think it was this one. Oh, I have him on a horse. That was a good one also. Yeah, so here he is. It looks like a Lipizzaner, doesn't it? It has his knees, you know, pulled up for that trot. Very, very pretty horse. Yeah, it's a tall horse also, and it's very well defined. And he does have a spear. So he was definitely, out there jumping up on his horse and then not afraid of war. And in this one, I'm seeing him with a spear, and on his deathbed also he had a spear, so he really did like that. Now they did have that time where they were jousting, remember? This was all in that era, so he could have been a jouster on his horse as well, like during battle. Not afraid to be one of those. So yeah, I'm gonna see what else I've got on this page. They do have him in a funny little stone here, but it makes him look so short. And then they have another one. They have him when he has amazingly long legs. So his proportions are all different. Yeah, here he is on a horse with his big long jousting sword again. So yeah, that's something to consider with him. Here he is, another with his horse and the spear. Very much. That was his weapon of choice, wasn't it? And it's a thin weapon, it's a light weapon, but yeah, it's almost like a bamboo stick if you ever worked with one of those. He probably knew how to twirl it and put it down next to him in a hurry, in a fashion. But it's not really something you wear on your belt. So he could never really let go of that spear. And you wouldn't leave it on your horse. So everywhere he went, the spear went with him. That's kind of neat, isn't it, to think about. That's a beautiful horse also. Whoever's done the musculature on that one, that was beautiful. And more castle. This one is All Hallows Church. Not a castle, sorry. Goodmanham. He's in relationship with that one also. But yeah, I mean, that's a serious, hey, I've got my, I got my sword here. Yeah, I'm gonna go down these. Yeah, with this one on his deathbed, they have him with really, really long legs. He looks well loved, doesn't he? I'll try to shrink myself here even more. Okay. So yeah. There's the now that would be one of his wives, I take it. And look at this, there's his dog again. So or another dog, but yeah, loyal dog by his side. And here he has long thighs, and so it's showing that he has a very long stature in a way, almost 6 feet. So I'm not sure why some of the other images show him up to be shorter. And look how they bound and wrapped and wrapped those boots on. It's pretty incredible. What else have I got here? There's always somebody there carrying a flag, their reign of the region, and it would have their particular emblem of Northumbria on it. Yeah, so he was a very, very popular character. And from the north, from the Viking north, no doubt. Here there's he's showing this battalion, like a razor, like a mohawk, right along the center of his helmet. That's pretty ferocious, I would say. Yeah, so let's go see if there were any others for him. I know I was supposed to talk about the other guy as well, but he has really interesting images. And I imagine he's buried here, his cross in Dartmoor, Devon. Now why they have him in Devon now, I don't know. But it's something there. Oh, they have that same image. Did I show you that one in color? Gosh dang it. They had a one in color. Yeah. So there it is with this stock Alame. It almost looks like a black dog, dark brown black. Very, very nice, almost like a Labrador, but what have they done to his ears? It looks like they did something to his ears to make him more like a pincher. So his ears have been fiddled with. Very unusual that that would be in the image. Or it's just the artist couldn't paint ears of dogs. That's another possibility. But yeah, his ears are in an odd place. They're like the Doberman pinschers. They really sling them different, don't they? Yeah, so here you can see now the flag. It's a red with a bit of a silver. And he has a silver hat, silver suit, and it with gold. He's into gold. And she's into gold. They're really loving that. All right, so I'm gonna journey out of this one. That was the death of him, and they called him the Strong, Seward the Strong, Seward the Strong. And Seward he was. He came from the other side of the ocean. So he was a bit of a conqueror, you know, he just showed up and claimed. Now, did I show you this garden already? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, what is that one? Not sure, not sure. Yeah, I think we've reached the end of some good images of the boy. Next, we're gonna have I'm gonna go towards the Earl. Now, well, he was Earl also, but I'm pretty sure he just went by Siward more and showed up with a spear and everybody was okay. All right, so now we have the Uhtred here, and this would be his wife's father's father. So his wife's grandfather. And yeah, here they have him looking quite angelic almost. And there's a lot of weirdo images of him, all different. What is that? That's going to be his big castle, Uhtred the Bold. Of something of something. Now they'll show me this and I'll go and it won't have a for sure, but it could be his castle. Yeah, Bamber. Yeah, Bamber Castle was an acquaintance with. So yeah, that really was his. And there it is, it's right by the ocean. That is so interesting. So they're right there by the sea. Okay, so it's not an inland location at all. If you've been to Yorkshire Dales or anything like that, it's not back in there. These guys are really hunkered down at the ocean side. Now they're saying that this is in Durham. And in Durham, I actually stopped there and I bought two blankets and in like a little shop, because the industry and all of that of wool, and I didn't know at the time that the wool creatures are treated so badly. But yeah, they're wool blankets, and I still have them. I think I'm even sitting on one. But yeah, they have like that. They put all the, oh, this like the Scottish tartan look on a lot of them. And I think I got green and blue. And yeah, so anyway, so that area was the same area where they're just fighting and fighting over the north. And this is the one. This guy here is the one who had the women. After Malcolm tried to invade, Malcolm is saying, "Hey, I'm gonna take over further south and invade Northumbria and claim it." Well, he was defeated to the point of the soldiers, you know, there it is, man, washing the heads. So where did they put the heads on the pole? I don't know, but somewhere around here, somewhere around this castle, no doubt, somewhere in the towns. So yeah, it was kind of a scary group, huh? Powerful with their fear tactic. Well, no, I don't think I'm going to invade you today. My friend is on a pole. He'll stay over there, you know. They do try to make it look almost romantic in this one. It has like the water washing up. It's a very, very stranded one, isn't it? Almost like the water would go all the way around when the tide roars in. There is a village in England, though, also, so it's possible that that's where the heads were, not just the castle. I imagine it would be the, oh no, they're saying that the village itself is right behind the castle. Oh, it's one of those sneaky images. Okay, so here we have the image. And so there would be right next to the phone box of London, we're having the heads on poles lining the streets. Scotland is not gonna invade. So you could see how formidable they were. Absolutely formidable. And in a way, the stop for Scotland to invade England and claim it. You know, we have this big monster there. Yeah, it would have been a real halt to their plans. I haven't really gotten into all my Scottish lines, but they're on the other side fighting, and their heads are ending up on poles. So yeah, that's kind of funny, huh? When you have both sides. It's really funny. Yeah, a lot of that's going on. Just the ruling classes, if it's all it really comes down to, the ruling classes ended up fighting each other, and that ends up being your line. That's the way it goes. Yeah, it's kind of a very, very interesting castle. I'm gonna give it a star. Plus, like 5-star. There's a bunch of them out there, but this one is a really gracious size. It could be the grounds themselves within there, kind of like a Carcassonne in size. So yeah, that's pretty neat. They're gonna show a lot of it. Oh, they could even do better, I think, on their images. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to Uhtred himself here. And we'll try to find him. No, that's not him. That's the guy who wants to play him in the movies. And Family Search says he looks like this guy. I don't know. And what do we have? Wikipedia? Wikipedia, do they have a claim of what he looks like? No. They don't want to claim what he looks like. It's all unknown. Okay. Well, so we're never going to know from Wiki today. We're going to find out. I guess we're going to have to go Family Search, believe it or not. There he is. A little cutesy there. 45, he died. He passed away. Well, he was killed, no doubt. Now, I don't know what kind of weapons he was using. He looks so nice, doesn't he? He looks like, you know, just like an angel in a way. And yet, he apparently, not at all. He was the bold. He doesn't actually look that bold here. They almost make him look effeminate. So I've got to find a better photo of him. I can't believe he would be that effeminate looking. Okay, so let's go find straight up images. No, these are all these old, another one, like romantic whatevers. And these guys want to play him in the movies. So no, I'm not getting actual image of him. Maybe here, the Throng of War moment in a painting. Yeah. Let's try them out. Hub pages. Yeah, this is all about this Cnut. Now, Cnut really had a big land. He was into that part of the British Isles, and then he was over there, Denmark, over there in Sweden. A big lands up there that he was claiming all as his. So he was definitely a character. And again, we have this line. I can look at this real quick. This might be good for you guys since we're supposed to be looking at genealogy. No, I don't want to look at that guy thinking he's Ironside. The Wessex kings. Yeah, the Wessex kings. Yeah, we have them. Gosh, dang it. I wish I wasn't so old already. Okay, Northumbria, there it is, the lie of the land. It's just ruining everything, isn't it? Anyway, Viking Age of England, they're calling it. So they're really pushing these guys back to being the Vikings. That would explain part of the brutality. Yeah, this is the one I was looking for here. Tostig is accepted as Earl. Well, that is not the one I was thinking of. This is another guy. Right. All right. I was really looking for old Uhtred. Now Uhtred has run away. Now these are good also. Isn't that interesting? If you say like you have a herald in your line, I have a lot of heralds in my line. And here's the whole region of England being called herald. That's kind of funny. That would be Cornwall, Somerset, over here, Isle of Wight, that whole zone, Bristol, Gloucester, and yeah, so that would be interesting. So here's Malcolm. Yeah, Malcolm was the one that was trying to get in there and fight, and ended up with heads on a platter. So that just didn't work. What was London in that zone, by the way? We're looking at Waltof, it would be the Waltof or the Yirth. The Leof vine. This is the one of the most expensive regions of England right now. This zone, it always has been. We have the Edwins and the Bledian, I guess they're Bledian from the Wales. Yeah, this is anywhere where the River Thames was near Uhtred, but then if they're south of the River Thames, much more higher price on the property. It's pretty there. I won't go overboard on it, but yeah, it is quaint. All right, so next, I don't know, this page is going on and on with a lot of white space and I'm not seeing enough image. Darn it, guys, there, wait, what is this one? Yeah, that Morcar region. I'm not sure, here we are. No, it's not showing. I just want to show an empty page. Darn it. Edward the Confessor, it was around all the same time. I haven't gotten into him yet. I think so. I think I'll make a video on him. But not today. I think this is a blank out only page. Yeah, they're calling that castle Bamberg, Babenberg also. Oh, darn it. I wanted to see Uhtred in his war gear. And I'm not seeing him in war gear. They're showing a Siward more so. And darn it. And then they sang Tostig. I really wanted the bold here. No, gosh, these guys want to be like, hey, put me in the movies. Put me in the movies. I'll shave my head like any way you want, as long as I can be Uhtred. And it's probably not spelled that, sounding that way. It's probably Uhtred, Uhtred, like Uhtred. Yeah. Anywho, I think that's it for today. Darn it, I didn't get his weaponry. No confirmation if he was a spear taker like his like Siward, his great, well, it would just be his grandson's husband. No, his granddaughter's husband. No, so he would have died by then though. And then they do have this one. Well, I'm sorry, I'll take it back. We'll take this photo. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, here we are at this. Histories and sagas. Well, they're just regular old swords. That's all they're gonna show. That's all we get out of them. More kind of Grecian looking though in their dress, aren't they? Even though there's snow on the ground, a little Grecian. Yeah. And you note the Viking, the emblem, that King of Alba, they're trying to say King of Alba, Kingdom of Alba. being the dragon. So yeah, he's a pretty cool fellow, that one. There was one other in here that was also highlighted. No. Gosh dang it, Jusa. Where did it go? Yeah, because that was, it's almost like that's what they were born with in their little crib. This is what you get, you know, this is your sword. What type are you gonna use? Now this one here, there's a video. That's something to check out if you really want to watch more. It's called The Real Uhtred of Babenberg. And so this will be really interesting, no doubt. It's probably done by professionals. Unlike me, I'm just a pretend. All right, so let's turn that off. I was looking for a little bit more of his there you go. We have him here with a sword. Now we have him here with a spear. Okay, come on, which one is it? We do still have the round, like a tondo, a shield. So they are they're carrying that one, you know, it just wraps right there on their wrist. And though that's a clever little gadget. Whoever came up with that one. My gosh. Yeah, so they have him here usually with a sword. This is like a Clydesdale now he's on. Clydesdale. Big horse. Yeah, but definitely with a sword more so. And yet here he has a spear and a sword. So he's got both. So maybe he did a little bit of that running with a spear sometimes to kill, and then later on used that for the beheading, because they did behead, you know, and those were pretty sharp bastards. Yeah, they would kill and then behead. Not really my cup of tea. not a walk in the park, but it was an aggressive time. Probably one of the most aggressive war times in history. You can just say, well, I don't know. I just think today I'm gonna just go out and kill someone. Or it's just every single day on the defense, you know. War just went on and on and on. They were just lifetime soldiers. But were they soldiers like today? They were probably a little bit more independent. I don't believe they were soldiers like today. I believe they were men who had the swords, and if they didn't like their leadership, it was all in question. I cannot believe that they were blindly following the action. The violent action was just way too brutal for a blind follow. But, you know, who knows? And this guy, he's like, who's Uhtred the Bold? Who was he? He wants to talk about him. And put him on a TV show. Here they have him on a white horse, like it's all romantic. But I imagine the horse had a lot of blood on him from war and battle also. So yeah. It's not really anything but a hardship time in history. Just a hardship time. And this guy is a pretty, looks like he's really done the acting of it a lot in this show called The Last Kingdom. Yeah, so that might be the associated movie for Viking fans with Valhalla in it. So, yeah. Now here they have him in a, they even turned him into a pauvre or something, so, or a cad. So he's got his sword and he's got this. Now he's apparently slung that over on his back, wearing it like a sombrero back there. So you can put it back there if you really need. If you really need to. Well, now he's got a kind of a black horse in this one. So now watch out for those movies. Who knows? Who knows? Yeah, and this looks like the sword of, I believe this is his son, Aeldorman. Now, am I a relative of that one? I've got Uhtred in this one. Is that the same guy? Uhtred could be the same guy. The way they go about their names, you know. Anyway, I think I've gone on and on tonight, and that's all I'm going to be able to talk about. But definitely Siward was the sword man. And I don't mean to be going all flashy here all over the place, but I have to. Yeah, so Ealdulf. Is that the one? The Lord of Bamber? Ealdulf? No, Uhtred. Well, find him. That would be on the family tree one. That would, oh, that's with this. It should be that one, though. Eadwulf. Yeah, he should be listed as I think he's the same guy. This one, Eadwulf. I think it's the same one. So in the naming, he probably has a lot of different names. I do find that they're very restrictive here on family search, and when you go seek out, I said, well, he can be called this name and call that name. So you probably find out that he has a lot of other names. So if I check him out real quick, see if he's the same that they're talking about. Not that one. I don't want the picture. I have Eadwulf or Eadwulf. So in a way they had him written in as Eadwulf twice. So that would be wrong. So yeah, so there's an error on the family search page. They're linking him to the same name twice. So yeah, they're not always exact. Uhtred is the one, I believe, is the one I was somehow, was it Uhtred? My memory is, yeah, Uhtred. That's the one that I've got the association with in this seek out. Poor guy, he died 933. So, he's Uhtred the First. He was king of the Saxons. His father was Eadwulf, king of the Saxons. Okay, so now I'm really getting confused because I have a feeling these guys are coming in earlier. Not later. Now they've got it all. Yeah, no, it's the same time, 994. It would be the same one. Okay. I think so, yeah. No, 933. No, it's a different one. So this would be like a his like a grandfather along the line somehow. They are so confusing. Son of Ed Wolf. Maybe they got them all mixed up. If I go back to the this one, Eofed, Eofelid. She's the one to hunt. Yeah, it's a chore, isn't it? Okay, this would be a little bit of a link through. Now they have, oh, he would be Aeldred the second. So that's what happened. It just wasn't, he wasn't listed as a second, I don't think. All right. Northeast. And he was this Bernicia is the Earl of Bernicia, and I guess they called that area Northern Northumberland. So that would explain it. So Eod Wolf was murdered though by Siward. These guys are just violent fighters, and they, like they were saying, feuders. But did I get to the bottom of this guy, Aeldred of Bamber? Issue. Who was his issue? The third daughter was Eofed. Yeah, so that would have been the father. And then his father was the one that I was looking at. Who was his dad? Son of Uhtred. There he is. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, okay, here we go. Uhtred was murdered by Thurbrand. Okay. So yeah, they don't say how he was murdered, but just was. But yeah, they were just a real fighty group. And I'm not sure why they were Viking descent, all of them, but it could have been that they just fell apart. Some were with the Cnut and some weren't. So maybe it was a, like, you're an ally with a Cnut guy, and the Cnut guy really wanted that whole region. And maybe these guys said, no, this is my region, so. So in a way, it was a bit of a real, if you think about it that way, I'll try to find the Cnut territory. It was pretty massive. This old boy. Yeah, they don't want to show it now. But yeah, they're doing the jousting. Here it is. This is a great map of it. Okay, yeah, the Cnut territory, England, Denmark, Norway. So if you think of it this way, these guys are here. They're in this zone. And they're saying, no way, we don't want this guy here anymore. So Uhtred is getting Cnut out. And then the next guy, Siward, is saying, well, I'll be friendly with Cnut and be part of that, and then keep my zone. But really the bold was the one who was Uhtred, who really wanted to get him out. And it didn't work because his grandson-in-law, I guess they would call him, ended up in Canute's hands also. And all in all, there's the Holy Roman Empire just waiting with its claws. Just wait, you guys are going to get across soon. Okay, guys, no more heads on a pole. The cross is showing up. And, you know, I don't know. They did a little bit of the heads on the pole with the cross time, but they did do away with it, didn't they? Okay, I'm going to stop this major recording.